Y'all, once again, it's on. We back at you one more again, y'all mean? Real Kids TV in the house like kitchen sinks. Hopefully you like the video. Feel free to comment, subscribe if you haven't already. Subscribe to the channel, hit that post notification so that anytime we bring you this heat and this action, guess what? You're amongst the first to receive it. Now, with no further ado, I want to get into the Lil Boosie interview. I believe it was part three, if you will. Lil Boosie, man, I was proud, for the most part, to watch that interview. He seemed real humble. He seemed like some people has really gotten in his ear, and he's listening. And his whole body language, everything was different about Lil Boosie in his interview, you know? As though somebody's finally reaching him. See, I never had a problem with Lil Boosie. Only problem that I had was with the people that he kept around him, because he had yes people around him. He didn't have no people. But the reason he had yes people is because they were afraid to tell Lil Boosie anything in fear that, you know what, going home. Now they back in the hood. He sends them home. So that's the only thing I was saying. You know, Lil Boosie, man, I ain't never really been a big fan as far as a music fan like that. But I've always cheered him on. I wish him well. I want him to do well. I hope he comes out of this case. I think that he can beat this case. But he has to look himself in the mirror. And I seen that where he just recently started going to counseling, therapy, anger management. And that's the first step, man. Looking at yourself. Understanding that, hold on, it can't be everybody else around me. It has to be me. Why am I so angry? I'm successful. I got a lot of kids. Everybody's healthy. I'm good. Why am I so angry all the time? And he took the first step by addressing that and going to a meeting. So I applaud Lil Boosie, man. You know what I'm saying? I definitely applaud. I'm not trying to kick. Maybe you feel like everybody's trying to kick you, Lil Boosie. And some are, because you just got haters out here. But some people are not trying to kick you. It's just, you talk so much and you stand on so much. So now that you're in the situation, in the scenario, it's like, okay, let's see, Lil Boosie, if you stand on what you've been talking about all this time. And I think that, just my opinion, that's all it is. I don't think people are really kicking you. You got so many people that's cheering you on. You're always going to have some haters. You're always going to have some people that, you know, don't wish you well. But you got to understand too, Lil Boosie, you was going back and forth with dudes before you caught this case. They're not going to stop just because you caught this case. You a million-dollar dude. Multi-million-dollar dude. These dudes is eating off, you know, talking about whatever you may be going through or whatever you speak on, guess what? You giving them, you know, they can speak on what you spoke on. So in turn, creates views, content. So I'm saying, like, Lil Boosie, man, I applaud you. There was one thing, though. However, there was one thing that I didn't like. You got to get you some good PR people around you, man. Don't just invite Vlad to your house and you don't got no PR people around you that really, really know what you're doing. Or even if you don't invite him to his house, don't go to his studio, meet up with him, whatever. Have you some good PR people. When you made that statement, basically you was talking about when you was at the BET Awards. I can't get high. So I was drunk as hell, man. I was drunk from the time I went in until the next day. No, Lil Boosie, you don't say that, man. Come on. Come on, Lil Boosie, you don't say that. Why do you gotta let everybody know you was drunk? In a lot of cases, when you out on bond, they can revoke you for getting drunk. Now, I don't know the stipulations of your bond, but I've been on bond a few times. And you don't let them people know that you was drunk out of your mind. That's not what you do, Lil Boosie. You know what I mean? So you need you. I understand you said you're going to cut some people off. But just understand, the people that you cut off, before you cut them off, understand why you're cutting them off. You see what I'm saying? Because some people, man, they just may, they fear you. They fear going home. You need to watch the 21 Savage interview, the way he said, man, all my dudes around me can chastise me. They can tell me, hey, bro, that was some fuck shit you did, man. Without worrying about the consequences of me telling you the truth. So it's not necessarily that you need to cut people off. And then, you know, maybe you do need to cut some people. I don't know. But I'm just saying, have a sit down with your people. Let them know that you've had a change of heart. And guess what? Y'all see me doing some ignorance? Man, feel free to tell me. No longer weaponize your money. No longer have people thinking like, man, Boosie sends me home. What am I going to do now? But at the same time, the people you cut off is the people that's not bringing anything to the table. Okay, y'all got to do something. You know, find out everybody's strengths. Find out what you need, you know what I mean, to grow as a team. It can't be just Lil Boosie and then all my stragglers. No, y'all need to grow as a team. You know what I mean? Okay, you good with graphic art? Cool. You do this. You good with production? Cool. You good with audio, video, whatever? Cool. Even if they got to go to school for a year or two or whatever, to strengthen your team, man. And that's how you strengthen it. But all this old in the streets and I expect everybody to be the way that I am and this and that. Nah, that's not how life works. You are who you are. Just because you paid somebody's bond for $1,200 for them to get out and you didn't know them, that's a great thing you did. But guess what? The average person ain't doing that. And you can't expect the average person to do that. That's something I would do. See what I'm saying? You got a big heart. But at the same time, don't look at a person as they not real because they don't do the things that you would do. Because everybody don't think the same. But I definitely like the interview you did. I see some contrition. I see that you finally starting to understand, like, hold on, man. I got to check me. And I see you really making it right with your daughter. I do. Because you taking a look at yourself first, man. A lot of people don't even, they won't even go to that first meet. Because they think that it's everybody else. But nah, you understand. You understand that it's me as well. So I got to change some things, man. Or things are going to continue to go the same as they've been going. So as I said, you know, several times already, I like the interview. I see what you all trying to do. I see the picture that you're painting. I see that, you know, you're trying to show the world a different side of you. A little Boosie of who he really, really is. And, you know, just keep it up, man. All you can do is just do what you do, man. Continue to strive to be better, be a better person. And I think you're going to come out, however the situation plays out, you're going to come out on the positive side of this, man. Real Kids TV. Hopefully you all like the video. Feel free to comment. Subscribe if you haven't already subscribed. Share. Hit that post notification. Anytime I bring you this action, this heat, guess what? You're amongst the first to receive it, man. Y'all start sharing my videos, man. You know what I mean? I know I'm a small channel. But, we got a lot of positive insight and a whole lot of positive information, if you will. You know what I mean? Start sharing my videos for me one time. Can you do that for me? Would you do that? Real Gens TV, man. We out.